So what are the top five plastic surgery and aesthetic treatments now that people are regretting? It's not just celebrities, because as you know, people follow the celebrities. They follow what the celebrities are doing, so it becomes commonplace. Number one, you've likely heard of skin boosters. Skin boosters are using a cross-linked hyaluronic acid. You would have heard of things like Voluma of Juvederm, or now SkinVive, which is the skin booster that's out. This is the latest one, that you use a very small needle and you inject it all over the face, wherever you have lines. Most people are talking about treating smile lines in the edge of the mouth with it, but it's used everywhere to give a little boost to your skin, to kind of mimic what that fat pad would be if your fat pads were healthy. Well, here's the reality. Make your fat pads healthy. Don't add a face full of cross-linked filler. It makes no sense to have filler in your face that draws water in at some point, that moves, that migrates, just to mimic what you already have in your face, which is your fat pads. And you're going to want to watch my videos on how to make your fat pads healthy with skincare, and if you want, with platelet-rich fibrin or your all-natural blood injections. But skin boosters with those types of fillers, I'm not a fan of, and people are already regretting them. No one wants a face full of filler. We all know what that looks like. Number two, the lip lift. Yes, people are still getting a lot of lip lifts. The reason is, as we age, the bone in the face changes, the dentition, the teeth change, and that happens. The distance from the nose to the upper lip lengthens. And when it gets longer, it has a bit of an untoward look. The face is all made up of angles and proportions, and there's beauty angles. And when we deviate greatly from those angles, it becomes something that people look at. And in this case, we as humans have determined that that length, as it increases, is an unattractive look. This is one of the reasons you see the trend of overlining the upper lip with lipstick, giving the illusion of a shorter distance. Even the young kids are doing it now. And so people want to decrease this distance, lift the lip. The problem becomes, as people age, the skin then once again relaxes, it moves down, and what does it reveal? It reveals a scar. And of course, the upper lip, it moves, and it moves in a very certain way when people speak and articulate and eat. And when you mess with Mother Nature and you cut up here, a lot of times, the mouth doesn't move normal. Now, there are a lot of people that get a nice result from it, but be mindful who you see and how much of a result you go for. If you go for too much, it's under too much tension. And of course, technique is key. But lip lifts often cause damage and change the way you look in a way that people just don't like. Number three, the BBL. The butt lift, Brazilian butt lift. Now, it can be done with fat, it can be done with Sculptra, and unfortunately, some people do it with PMMA, or basically plastic, a plexiglass that's put in the buttock. It's not built for that, and a lot of people ask me about putting fillers in the breast or the buttock. All bad ideas. But the reason people aren't liking their BBL, of course, we hear at all social media and all the news about people dying from it, because you get fat that can migrate up to the lung, and that's a pulmonary embolus, and that's associated many times with death. So there is some morbidity and mortality associated with the procedure. But here's another reason that you may not calculate. We follow trends of people, and certain Hollywood trends were the big butt and the wide hip was in. Well, now, of course, we want to make more money. We changed the trend. The trend is now thin. Thin is in. The body of the 80s and early 90s, the fit model. So people who've had their butt lift or their BBL are reversing it. But at the same time, a lot of practitioners want to make money off of the BBL, creating it. So there's that dichotomy, and people are still getting them done, only to find out when they turn on their favorite reality TV show, it's out of favor and they're trying to get it removed. Never a good look. It kind of looks like a diaper after that. BBLs are often now regretted, therefore. Next still is microneedling, RF microneedling. That means instead of needles going into the face, they're hot needles. Either the tip heats or the whole shaft of the needle heats. But what happens is it's supposed to just tighten your skin. Or in my case, I use it to remove fat in the lower face. But the problem is the settings, who uses it, and the type of device makes such a big difference. The people are getting fat removed from where they want it, which is the upper face, and they're also getting skin damage from discoloration, or what we call PIH, which is post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, because the heat leads to a reaction in the skin, melanin is produced, and you get little brown spots and dots where all the needles go in. Because when you use RF microneedling, there's about, my device is 49 needles, boom, that go in at once and come out. Only the tips of my needles heat, because I'm trying to get rid of lower face fat. But someone who doesn't know how to use it or uses the wrong settings, the fat reduction setting in the upper face, imagine losing your forehead fat or your under eye fat that's so precious and important. So RF microneedling, it is one of the top procedures that people regret, but really not because it's a bad procedure in and of itself, it's because the person using it used it poorly. But RF microneedling, don't worry, regular microneedling, many of you are doing at home with a pen, there's no heat, there's no electricity involved, that does not cause face fat as long as you're not infusing the wrong product. Finally, people are still getting the buccal fat removed. You know about it. I'm feeling a lot of people below where they had their buccal fat removed because it made them look too old. So when you take the fat here, part of the reason is you want to get that selfie look, but you remove the fat to get the higher cheek look. But when you remove fat, the face looks elongated and that looks old, because at 20, your bone, especially for a female, is different than at 30. You mature into your bone to 30. When you remove the buccal fat, you mature 3 to 4 times faster. And there's an easy way to get that hollow cheek look. It's simply add filler. You can use dissolvable if you're not sure. That way you can take it out. Or you can use permanent like Bellafill, which is PMMA, which is a permanent product. And that builds up the cheek without having to remove the fat here. Now, it's fairly easy to replace this area here. But it does take a fair bit of money. So think $3,000 to $7,000 plus every 5 to 6 years to replace it. So buccal fat removal is one that Hollywood brought on. And yeah, the 24-year-olds looked amazing. But then at 30, they're now looking 40. So they're not looking younger. And the regular people who followed the celebrities down that rabbit hole regret getting it done. Now you're going to want to watch this video on how to keep your facial fat healthy and lifted, and one down here on how I use RF microneedling to reduce the fat in the lower face to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.